Welcome to Learning the YouTube APIs in 10 Minutes. I'm your host, Jeremy Walker. I'm a YouTube developer advocate, so let's get started. I'm first going to talk to you about the analytics API itself, and then I'm going to talk to you about defining a report and taking that information and testing your report so you can basically get an idea of if it's working or not. And then from there, we'll take that information and quickly move it into some code. Now, the first three sections are doesn't matter what language you're using. The last section I will use Java, but you can see from the end of it when you actually go through it that you could apply this to any language you want to go with. So the YouTube Analytics API, if you're used to YouTube, you know that there's a bunch of data and we provide an analytics window where you can get a lot of that in a dashboard. But you may want to mash up those reports in different ways or combine it with other data or even automate processes to handle that data, and we let you do that through our API. It's a HTTP RESTful API, so you can write the URIs yourself, or we provide 9 libraries, so you can, you know, pick the library that fits your language. We also have a lot of examples, so you don't have to write code from scratch. You can just grab ours and kind of reach and tinker with it a little bit to fit your needs. So let's get started. And define your report. So there's two types of reports you can get. You have a channel and a content owner report. Today we're going to cover a channel report, which is basically just getting the information just for a specific channel. There's also for partners who have multiple channels, they can do a content owner report where they can get information on one of their channels or all their channels and kind of bundle it together. I will be giving a talk on that at I/O that will be recorded, so you'll be able to watch that as well if you're interested. But again, this presentation here actually applies to both, so I would definitely recommend going through this and then jumping to that. So when you start with a report, after you've decided on whether it's going to be a channel report or a content owner report, now you have to decide, okay, what information do I need? And that's where the big three come into play. So there's metrics, which are the most important one. Those are going to be any sort of activity or user activity that we record. So views, likes, uniques, subscribers added, lost, all that great stuff. So that's kind of the metric you're looking for, well, metric, of course. And then we kind of bundle those together in what are called dimensions. So when you get views, you have to get a dimension on it. So you can decide on you want it by days, or you want it by week or month, or maybe you want it by country. So we give you a bunch of those options so you can kind of bundle it how you want. Now, if you don't want all that information and you want to filter it a little bit, we have filters so you can, for instance, if you want views and you take them by country, but maybe you're only interested in Japan, then you can set a filter to only get Japan. And after you come up with the metrics and dimensions and possible filter you want, then you're going to want to look at our page that's labeled Available Reports. And I can show that to you right here. So if you just search for the YouTube Analytics API, this will be what comes up. And under reports, because you have to choose one, you can choose channel reports, which is what I'm doing here. And you can see available reports. So what this is it's a bunch of information about what metrics and dimensions work with each other, because you can't just throw them all together and hope it'll work. There's only certain reports that'll work with each other. So you have to kind of go through this and make sure it's working. So in this case, I'm actually going to look at just getting the views. Now you can see here for metrics, I could combine a bunch of these. I could combine views, comments, favorites added, a bunch of great stuff. And then I can do it on a dimension by day, 7-day totals, or a month. I'm actually going to show you an example in month. But you can combine those two. And then on the right, you can filter it either by country or by video, which is a video ID, and then from there by country if you choose to do those. So again, you kind of put your report together, get a rough idea with the big three, and then you look at the available reports for your either the content owner or channel, in our case channel, and you kind of decide what you want to do from there. So now that you kind of got the report you want, or you know, possibly reports you want, the next step is to go to the API Explorer. Now this is a really, really powerful tool that's available on our website that basically lets you run reports without writing any code, including authorization. So because with the Analytics API, you do have to authorize, this is really important, because then you get the report working and in great shape before you go to the code. I see a lot of people who start writing code and they say they're having problems, when it's just they never had a proper report to begin with. So always start with this. That's a best practice. And how this works is you just search YouTube Analytics API, and this will come up. And if you go to the reference link, you'll see we have some great information. Again, this is a RESTful API, so if you don't want to use our libraries and you want to just use construct the URLs yourself, you can do that. We list all the parameters, and then we even provide some examples in Python, JavaScript, and Java and Ruby, and then we have some more libraries beyond that. But at the bottom of the page is this API Explorer is what we call it. And so this is where you can try out your reports before you dive into code. So you can see in the right here, there's this authorize request. I just hit that I want to authorize that. And then now it's authorized. So now I can run request as if I've gone through the whole OAuth2 process, which it actually is done on the background. So let's get started. So you can see at the bottom here, we have metrics, dimensions, filters, which were the big three I'm talking about. You can see above that start date and end date. It's pretty self-explanatory. But at the top, you can see IDs. And this is what you actually use to specify which channel report you want. So do you want a channel report or a content owner report? If you're doing a content owner, you just type in content owner, double equals, and then your content owner ID. But in this case, we're doing a channel report, so you just do channel equal, and then you'll do your channel ID. Now, you're probably not going to know your channel ID. Most people don't. It's this long string with a bunch of numbers and letters. So that actually you have to get from the data API. So we have another API that's part of the YouTube API family, which is called the data API. And this lets you do most everything you can do on YouTube. And one of those things is to get information on your own channel. So we're going to actually do that. And if you just search for the YouTube data API, it'll be the first thing that comes up. It's also in the same area as the analytics API. But here you see V3 comes up. And if you expand the reference, you'll see there's a channel. And I actually want the list function. So again, this lists out, this looks probably almost just like what you just saw in the analytics API page. But you can see we list all the parameters so you can make the URL yourself. And then at the bottom, we have the API Explorer again. So this is great. This will actually give me my channel ID. So I'm just going to authorize this really quickly. And then I'm just going to put the ID. I could put snippet in if I want more information. And what's nice is you can just set mine equals to true. So this will get the channel associated with my account, which is right here, which is the perfect one. And here is the ID. So I'm just going to grab this and drop it here. Now I'm pretty much set to go, so I can start setting dates. I'm actually going to run a monthly report, so I'm going to run it for October and November. So I just set my times here. My metric, I just went views. Dimensions, I'm going to do month. And then I'm not going to do any filter at this point, but I hit execute. And then you can see it constructs the actual URL that goes out and a little bit more information, and then actually shows you the response. So you can see I got 1,100 views in November and in about 2,000 in October. So this is kind of a great tool. You can kind of mess around a lot with it till you get your report just right. And if you wanted to see filter, let's say I wanted to see country, we'll go with Brazil, see what that pulls up. And okay, I have 1 in 3 views in Brazil. So that's just an example of what you can do. If I wanted to, I could also drop a video in here and grab the video ID and put that in there or whatever it may be. So anyway, I have my report. I'm all set. Everything's looking good. The nice thing now is when I jump into coding, a lot of these parameters here map directly to the client library. So you pretty much know where to plug and play. So let's jump into that. So I've told you a little bit about the API. We've defined a report. We've actually run it. Everything looks good. Now we just add it to our code. So in this case, I'm going to use Java. If you look here, I'm actually constructing a HTTP transport object and a JSON factory. These are just to handle the requests and responses. And you'll see here is a credential. I don't have all the code in here. Again, this is an example that's online, so you can go grab it. There's a function, a larger function that takes care of the credentials for you. I'm not going to go over that, but it takes care of the whole OAuth2 process. So you can have a look at that. But the gist of this page is that, hey, I'm setting up a YouTube object and a YouTube analytics object. And the YouTube object maps to the data API because I need to get my channel ID right. The other one is the YouTube analytics, which is where I'm going to run my report. So next thing I need to do is first get the channel ID. And you can see I just call in the YouTube object channels list, which, and then I set mine, which if you look at the API Explorer, it's pretty much exactly what I set. So again, you don't actually need snippet. I was just showing that so you could see it was my channel. So I just set ID there because I just really need the ID. I execute it, and then I would get a list back of channels, and the first one would be my default one. So now that I have that, I just run a report, analytics.reports.query, and then I just drop in the same information, channel equals equals, and then that channel ID, and then I do the dates, and then set the dimensions, and then if I had any filters, I could set them there as well. And then I execute that. That'll give me a result table object that will have all the information that I can run through with like my own pretty print function. So let's see what that looks like. So this is all that stuff you just saw, and I'll actually clear this out and I'll rerun it. So this is actually going out, and I've already set up the OAuth. So you can see it pulled from my default channel, and you can see the numbers are the same. So that gives you an idea how to get started really quick. I've gone over the analytics API, kind of what it's used for, to mash up reports, automated things, and combine maybe external data with your data. I've gone over defining a report, testing it out with the API Explorer, which is very, very important. Make sure you do that. That's a big, big best practice. And then you port that over to your code. I happen to show Java, but again, you could have done this in Ruby, Objective-C, whatever you want. So now you should be set to go and have some fun with the Analytics API. So if you want to learn more, search YouTube Analytics API. You can follow my team on google.com/YouTube Dev. And then you can follow me as well, google.com/Jeremy J. Walker. Thank you for your time.